Hi everyone, today I'm doing a review on the book The Little Book of Hindu Deities by Sanjay Patel. And this is a paperback. It's about this thick and it covers most of the main Hindu deities. And it is a book that can be used as an introduction to the deities of the Hindu pantheon. So here we have the index page where it's given. The list is given of all the deities that have been mentioned in the book. This is the introduction that covers the story of the author, the illustrator, who, you know, about his childhood and why he got into this and stuff like that. And from here we start with the actual book. So the book is colorful and the artwork is pretty amazing. So we have the artwork on the right side and the write-up on the left side throughout the book. And one thing I really don't like about this book is that they have wasted all the space here and they have crammed the text into these tiny letters, which is very difficult to read. And most of the pages that have these light colored backgrounds, they have white text on them, which is again very, very difficult to read. So 800 rupees for this book I think is a sheer waste. It would have been still okay if, you know, the quality of the book was much better or the price of the book was lower. So see, again, this entire page is wasted and the text is crammed here, and the text is really, really tiny and quite difficult to read for both adults and children. And it covers most of the main deities, and the artwork is all very sweet and very cute, and like your child can easily, you know, relate to it. But the stories that or the write-up given here, the explanation about the deity is not as good, because somehow it is light-hearted and funny. And I mean, that's okay if you're like writing it for a child, but it still kind of, you know, like misses the essence of why we worship these deities, like what is so special about them. And some of the stories are like plain, really, really bull, like totally different from what is normally taught to us by our families and by word of mouth, or what you normally read in any other storybook like Amachitra Katha or, you know, other such books. So for example, the story of Saraswati is very, very different from what is normally known about her. And similarly, the story of Durga, she is a very, very famous deity, and in spite of that, there's hardly any, you know, like the story is not even given in full. And same goes for Lakshmi and, you know, such other deities. And like, as you can see, the background is really light and the text, white text on it, is very difficult to read. And it then covers all the 10 avatars of Vishnu. Again, the story kind of, you know, like fluctuates from what is actually like commonly known and what they have interpreted it as, and they've tried to make some kind of light-hearted comments about the story. And although the author says that it is not his wish to hurt anyone's feelings or anything about it, but it still feels a little weird because it is written in such a way that it is more like what, you know, foreigners to the religion actually think about the religion, which they know nothing about. And then we have the Hindu epics, which is like Mahabharata. It's not even the story of what Mahabharata was all about. The write-up here is about who wrote Mahabharata, which is not as important as knowing or teaching your child what Mahabharata is about. So there is nothing about Pandavas and Kauravas having a fight for, you know, why the war was waged. It's all about how Ganesha and Vedvyas sat down and wrote the story, which is not as important. And Bhagavad Gita, which is like a small part of the story of Mahabharata, that has been mentioned here, and that is just, you know, the scene is just described, not the essence of what Bhagavad Gita is. With Ramayana, at least they stuck to the story of Ramayana and they've given the story in short. Then we have the demigods, Agni and Indra, and they have stuck to mostly the mainstream storyline of what is commonly known about these deities. But again, in some places they do wander off the coast, and it's like something not normally, you know, like which is not commonly known. And I don't know if that is 100% true or if there is just some kind of fiction mixed into it. And then we had the nine planets, the Navgraha, and I really like this introduction because children and most adults don't know the story behind the Navgrahas or why they are worshipped, and I think this is a good way to introduce these topics. And then in the end we have the animal gods, which I wouldn't call them animal gods because they are all deities after all. And we have the Nagas and Garuda. Again, the story is kind of, you know, it goes off the mainstream and it wanders off a little. It is not what we commonly read about these deities. And then we have Surbi the cow, and then we have the chronology of creation, and they have just given about the different yugas and how the yuga cycle goes on. And that's about it, and that's the end of the book. So yeah, the book is all right. It is not worth spending 800 rupees on, but it's an okay sort of book, not terribly bad and not terribly good. It's an average book somehow. If you wish to introduce the concept of Hindu deities to your child, this might be the book for you. But if you wish to inculcate in your child the values and the morals and the reasons of why you worship these deities, why they are considered gods, and you know why we actually worship them, then this is probably not the book for you. So do check the book out in a library or, you know, in a bookstore if possible before buying it. Otherwise you are in for a surprise. So thanks for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel, and hope you enjoyed this and it was helpful. Thanks, bye.